Hey coders, and welcome to episode 2 now of our map service playlist on the Google Apps Script course. In today's episode, we're going to be learning about how to find and generate directions using nothing but the map service on Apps Script. So the top 8 methods which we will be overviewing today are new direction finder, set origin, set destination, add waypoint, get directions, add path, set avoid, and finally set mode. So let's hop on in over to the code and find our way through all of these methods. Let's say that your 6-year-old son's birthday is coming up, and one of the tasks that you have is in organizing his party. So one of the first things that you do is you create a Google form and you create a party invitation in Google Forms, asking guests to RSVP. So you're asking them if they can attend or not, what their name is, and then some other information. And then once they hit the submit button, you should be able to get their response. But one of the things that you want to do is when they hit this submit button, you yourself want to send an email to them acknowledging their submission, but then also creating a map for them from their address and giving them directions to the location of the birthday party. So you figure out that you want to do this through AppScript, so you go into the AppScript editor. So the first task that you need to do is to actually create the trigger. So once they hit this submit button, you want to automatically send them an email with all of this information. So as we've seen in our script app playlist, we can do this by saying script app dot new trigger for this form right here, and then we'll use the on form submit trigger for that. And then basically what that does is that once a form has been submitted, then we are going to automatically fire this function right here, send directions. So let's do that right now. We'll say create trigger, we'll run that, and we have just completed that execution, very simple. All right, so let's see what this function send directions does. Well, with this function, we are going to be getting the respondent email, storing that in a constant called email. We're going to be seeing if they can attend or not. If they can't attend, then we're just going to simply send them an email saying, sorry, you can't make it, maybe next time. But if they can attend, then we're going to proceed with the function. We're going to be getting their name, the guest address, their address, the address of Disney World, and the address of Universal Studios, their method of arriving. So if you remember from the Google form, they can select either driving, bicycling, busing, or walking. And then also we're going to see if they want to avoid anything, such as tolls or highways. And then once we have all of that information from the form, then we are going to create the map. So if you remember from episode 1 of this same playlist, we can create static maps by accessing the maps parent class and then accessing this method right here, new static map. So we're going to add a couple markers on that map. And then again, to naively or manually create a path with directions, you can do that by saying .beginPath and then ending it with endPath, and then in between those two methods, you can add as many points or addresses as you want. So I'm just going to add 3 for right now, the guest address, Disney World, and Universal Studios, get the blob, get the image blob, and then input that as an attachment, and then send that email. All right, let's see how this works in action. So I'm going to go into now my Google form, and I'm going to fill out some information. I'll say weissdav@sas.upenn.edu. Can I attend? Yes, I'll be there. My name is going to be Luke Young. My address will be 8200 Rocky Brook Way. Let's say I'll be arriving by driving. And for right now, I'm not going to avoid any of these right here. So if I hit this submit button, there we go, it says, thanks for responding, can't wait to see you there. And then if I go now into my email address, here we go, here is the confirmation message. It says, hi, Luke Young, thanks for coming to my party. And then it gives me a map right here. And as you can see, there are the paths right here, but it isn't really good directions because it's not really following any of the roads. I guess it would be good if I was flying there, but since I selected the driving mode, I'm going to be needing directions actually by taking the roads. And again, this is just a naive, manual way of doing that. All right, so let's see if we can actually create a map and a path that follows the roads all the way through to our waypoint and to our destination. All right, let's go back now into our app script editor. So the way to do that is we're going to need to create a directions object. We're going to need to create directions. So I'll come in here before we create our map and I'll say const directions. I'll say maps, and then the method that we need to do to create new directions is new direction finder, just like that. Just like maps.newStaticMap, we say maps.newDirectionFinder. And then in a similar vein, we are going to be chaining these methods together. So when we create a new direction finder, we first need to set an origin. So our origin is going to be the guest address. Again, we want to make directions from our guest home address to the location of the party. So we'll say set origin, we'll say set destination. The location of this party is going to be Universal Studios, so we'll put that in right here. And then if we want to add any pit stops along the way, say we think Disney World is so close to Universal in anyways that we want to spend a couple of hours there as a pre-party, then what we can do is we can say dot add waypoint, add in our waypoint, which is again our pit stop basically. So that's going to be Disney World. And then after we have our origin, waypoint, and destination, to actually create the directions, you say get directions. All right, and then this will return for us a directions object. And if you go in actually to the Google Maps API documentation, you can see that the directions object is actually a very large object. It contains a lot of information. And that's actually good if you think about it, because now we have access to a lot of data from Google Maps. But I would really recommend you going to this website right here and checking out the response object and seeing all the information that you have access to. But the thing that we're going to get right now is the routes. So let's say const best route is equal to directions dot route. And then the best route is going to be the first one in the array of routes. So we're going to get index 0, and that is the best route. So again, instead of just adding the path manually by saying begin path and end path, we are actually going to use a different method, which is dot add path. So with add path, you're basically just going to add a pre-existing path, and you can get that path from the best route. Actually, you can say best route dot overview polyline dot points, as you can see right down here. Here it is right here. So here is overview polyline, and here is the points, and here is your path. This is encoded polyline right here, but Google Maps API will know what to do with that. All right, so now we are adding the path. So we have now a map. We should have a map that has the actual path displayed on the map, but let's say that we also want to display the directions in the email body itself. Well, I have already written that code out right here, so let me just cut that. And once I have the best route, then I'm going to paste this right here. Basically, all that this is going to do is just go through the legs of the trip. Every leg of a route is, say, an origin to a waypoint, or if there's any pit stops, it's basically from pit stop to pit stop. So from origin to waypoint, or waypoint to destination, that is basically a leg. So we're gonna go through all the legs, we're going to get the steps of those legs, so basically any times we need to turn or anything like that, and then we are going to get the instructions in HTML from that step. We're going to get the distance and the duration, and then we're going to be storing that in a constant or a variable called HTML steps. So let me now just say, here are the directions to the party, and then I will add those HTML steps right here. All right, so that should be good now. It says, hi, thanks for coming to my party. Here are the directions to the party. And then in that, we're going to be HTML steps right here, which is going to include the HTML instructions of the best route. All right, so now let's save that and see if this works. I'm just going to refresh this page to resubmit the form. And if we go into our Gmail now, and refresh our inbox. Hopefully I did everything correctly. Let's see, let's go into our executions. And it says we failed in some way. Let's see, can I read property 0 of undefined? Oops, that's because this is going to be routes, not route. So if I save it again and refresh it, and go into my email address, refresh the page. There we go. We have now a new email and it says, "Hi, Luke Young. Thanks for coming to my party. And here are all of the directions right here." And if we go now to the end of the directions and see the map, there we go. Now we have a path that follows the roads all the way to our party. And if we zoom in a little bit, we can see that indeed this path does follow the yellow line roads right there. So I think that is pretty dang cool. We now have a path that follows the directions that we are given right here. All right, so let's go back into our AppScript editor and add a couple more things. So with our directions, we can add not only can we add the origin and destination, but we can also add things such as avoiding stuff. So if we say set avoid, we can say set avoid, and then we can say something like maps dot direction finder dot avoid. And then we can either avoid highways or tolls. And then we can say dot set mode and say maps dot direction finder dot mode. And then this is going to be the mode of transportation. So bicycling, driving, transit, or walking. But since we want to have this be, dynamic, right? We want to input the mode of arriving and the avoiding dynamically in here. What I'm actually going to do is I'm actually going to build this as a string. So let me just cut that right now. And I'll say this, but we're actually going to be, again, building this as a string. And then we are going to be getting the set mode as the mode of arriving to uppercase. And then if there is anything that we are avoiding, such as highways or tolls, then we are going to be appending that to the build directions. And now instead of just saying directions equal this, I'm actually going to say evaluate or eval build directions. And then this will evaluate this string as JavaScript. And then that will be able to get our directions. All right, so let me now save that again and edit my response. And instead of saying driving, let's say biking, and then we'll also say avoid tolls and highways, which I believe we're going to be doing anyways because we are biking. But if we say submit and go into our email address now, and refresh, there we go. We have now this, but it's all in biking directions. And if we go check out our map, as you can see, it's very long now, but if we go check out our map, then now we have the biking directions following just roads that we can take a bike on, and here we go with that map and all of the directions for that map. All right, guys, that is going to be it for this video. I hope you enjoyed this and learned something from it. Don't forget to, if you have any questions, then put them in the comments below. And also be sure to check out the Patreon page of this channel's Patreon. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons, and I'll see you in the very next episode.